has again numerous explanations, but summarized by the great master known as Shantideva. Not Shantideva, Aryadeva. Aryadeva is the foremost disciple of the Nagarjuna. Anybody he said, they said, three and the two more, and five qualities. First is, again I will list it, and then of course you will know that too. First is no partialities. No partiality or no bias.
Biases.
No biases. And smart or intelligence. Smart. And keen interested. Keen interested. And so that is three. Three is really important according to teachings. If you don't have that, even you met the qualified teacher, not going to see qualified teacher as qualified and see the wrong things. So it's not going to work. Beside that, two more, respect folks. Respect folks. And very attentive listening. These five are the five qualities of the disciples or the students. So this is what the teaching said. Qualified teacher, qualified student. Students. Then, this is again, of course, always in the teaching said, I'm sure you read the book, so many books, there's so many books, for both to be expert to find the qualified teacher. And the second one, you find a qualified teacher and to be expert to how to communicate and contact with qualified teacher. And the third is in the teaching said, and be expert to be expert and be practical to learn the knowledge and the teaching and gain kind of intention of the teacher, qualified teacher. If you do that, then you'll be able to become as very perfect practitioner and perfect lineage holder. So those are the teachings. That is the general approach. And then many times, also of course, you read too, there's many times they not really examined those qualified this and that. For example, all those 25 disciples in Guru Pema Sambhava, they did not examine Guru Pema Sambhava or the Master Chaitarakita. By seeing, by receiving the teaching, immediately observe that they're just highly ready, highly qualified, and they get enlightenment within their lifetimes. And they read the life story of the Malareva. Great Master Malareva, when he met Marva, he didn't exam, he didn't that. Even Marva did all those harsh things, he's so happy, so his courage and commitment, determination and devotion is so deep. And Malareva become as Malareva. And the Great Master Longchimpa, when he meet first his root teacher, Kumaranda, he didn't exam in a life, and immediately he contract and received teaching and become the Master, great masters. And then in India, there were so many great things. For example, Naropa met Vinatilopa. Again, he did an exam. Just hearing the names of the Tilopa, he contracted and received, even when all the different hardships, difficulties, he completely strong and solid and reached the enlightenment. So this is what the like, how those the great masters. Many times they didn't really examine and all these things, but they received the teaching and then practice it and reach enlightenment. So that is how this. But this time, His Holiness Dunyun would say here, I pay homage. Homage to my teacher. So his teacher, he's seeing as his teacher, as embodiment of all Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, every enlightened being, I pay homage. And that is in the Buddha teaching always said. Lama represented, or in the Buddha teaching, in the Vajrayana teaching, teacher represented all of those qualified teachers. That is for us, when we meet the qualified teacher, they are that represent all of that. So seeing that and pay respect and devote with full of devotions. So that is really about the teacher. And again, and then what in the teaching said also that generally, as he said, the ordinary teacher, there's no perfect teachers. There's always, I mean, it's no perfect teacher. There's no one we can find perfect teachers. There's always errors, mistakes. Maybe the teacher that we ordinary made, they are also in the path. They are practicing, so up there on that. But what in the Buddha teaching said, I'm sure many of you know that poor reliables. And what is called? Relying on the relying on the teaching, not to the individuals. That is, relying on the teaching, not to the individuals. Is it true? We came not to be enjoyed with that individuals, whatever that is, man and woman, whatever that is. But because we came because of the teaching. So that teaching is what we are really attracted. That is what we rely on. Then what is the teaching one? Teaching also has two. Word teaching and meaning teachings. Word and meaning. W-O-R-D. What Buddha teaching said? When it comes to the teaching, not relying on the word, but on the meaning. You have to not just what the language you use or something. Think of the meaning. That is more important. That's what we like to observe. It's the essence of the word. Word is word, but meaning is important. Then when it comes to the meaning, what in the Buddha's teaching said, relying on the ultimate meaning, not the interpretable meanings. I'm sure you heard those. Interpretable meanings. Relying on the ultimate meaning, not interpretable meaning. So that means can be interpreted. Ultimate meanings. When it comes to the meaning, relying on the wisdoms. Wisdoms. Then there's no merits, no mistakes, no disappointments. It's perfect. So therefore, what we want, what individual student, for example, us, practitioner, what we want? We want the teaching. Teaching, we want meaning. Meaning more unchangeable, ultimate meaning. Ultimate meaning, how we're going to absorb, not the conceptual level, but we're going to absorb that in the wisdom level. Absolute level. Those are the teachings. So that is what it is. And now, so that is really about this the post-Lamas, homage Lama.